Good morning, children. Dear children, today we are going to start a new chapter in English grammar, that is subject and predicate. Now, dear children, a sentence consists of two parts, or we can say a sentence is divided into two parts, subject and predicate. Look at, I have written a sentence. The sun rises in the east. Okay? Now, let me explain you first of all subject and predicate. Okay, bete? When we talk, we speak about some person, place or thing. When we are talking, we always speak about some person, place or thing. Or we are naming some person, place or thing. Whom we are talking about, what we are talking about, or we are naming persons, place or thing, that is known as subject. What we are talking about, whom we are talking about, that is known as subject. Now next, we say something about. Here we told, we talk about some person, place, thing. Now here, we say something about that person, place or thing, or we are saying about the person, place or thing, that is known as predicate. So here look at the sentence, the sun rises in the east. What we are talking about? We are saying about the sun. So the sun is subject. Now what we are saying about the sun? What we are saying, children? Rises in the east. So, we are saying the sun, subject, rises in the east. So, this word rises in the east is predicate. Okay, children? Once again, we say something about the person, place or thing, that is known as, that part of sentence is known as predicate. What we say about that person, place or thing, known as subject. Okay? Next one. One more thing to pay attention with here. Imperative sentences. In imperative sentence, where we express command, request and order, in those sentences with a, you is understood as subject. Let us see the example. Sit down. Here only the command is there. Sit down. Now, how to find out which is the subject here? This is predicate. Okay. Now, what we are saying, okay, we talk about whom? We are talking about the second person, you. So, here the proper sentence will be, you sit down, okay. So, here you is subject and sit down is predicate. Okay, children? Now, second example, do not tell lies. Again, here we have not written the subject on the board. Okay. Do not tell lies. Here, the proper sentence will be, you do not tell lies. So, here, you is subject and do not tell lies is predicate. Okay, bete? Do not tell lies. Lies is predicate. Okay, children? So, what we know? A sentence have two part, two parts mein divided hai. Subject, okay? Jiske baare hum baat karte hai. Predicate, uske baare hum kya baat karte hai. Thik hai? Now, we will do the exercise number in our book. We are going to do the exercise. Let us see the exercise, children. Okay? Now, our exercise, children. Divide each of the following sentences into subject and predicate. Okay, we have sentences and we have to divide which is the subject and which is the predicate. Now, question number one: the fox is hungry. The fox is hungry. We are talking about the fox. So the fox is subject, is hungry. Predicate. What we are talking about? Fox is hungry. Okay. Next. I have a house of my own. have a house of my own. We are talking about I, myself. I, subject. What we are saying? Have a house of my own. Predicate. Next question. Count your pennies. Now here, imperative sentence. Count your pennies. So here, which is the subject material? Actually, it is the predicate here and subject is you. You count your pennies. So you will be subject. Next. The sun gives us heat and energy. The sun gives us heat and energy. What we are talking? We are talking about the sun. So the sun subject. What we are saying today? Gives us heat and energy. So this is predicate. So dear children, you will have question. You have to divide subject and predicate. You can also write subject the fox, predicate is hungry. Or you will have columns. Okay. Now under the subject column you will write the subject and under the column of predicate you will write the predicate. Okay. Thank you children. Wish you all the best.